This video is about Strange's internal and external clock subsystem, Stagger, Clock Division, and VCO Mode. When you power Strange on, its internal clock defaults to 120 BPM, so you have a useful utility reference. But Strange's internal clock is really designed for experimental gestural control rather than precise tempo, so we're going to start by exploring the extremes of the clock, right up into audio, and back down to its lowest rate, 16 BPM. To further support more abstract work, there's the stagger control. This routes Strange's output back to the clock through an internal attenuverter. So clockwise of noon, higher notes play faster and increase the tempo, and lower notes play slower. Anti-clockwise of noon is the opposite effect. Use with large delta can produce extremely abstract wonkiness. As with Rho and Delta, stagger can be applied on a per-note basis too. I simply hold the note and turn stagger. Individual notes can therefore be made to last longer or shorter, like this C. One use of this might be to emphasize a tonal center. Now let's skip over the Fs more quickly so they act more like passing notes rather than structural ones. Another useful function is clock division. So let's zero the per note stagger and explore. I'm going to hold F sharp where all of the clock functions live and turn Z. We're dividing the clock so we count right to left from B lit, meaning divide by 1, to A sharp, meaning divide by 2. Turn a little more to count down 3 lights. And now 4. We counted 8 lights down to E, so that's divide by 8. The C would be 12, but Strange goes down to the more musically useful 16 by block filling lights back up to E for divide by 16, giving you whole notes from 16ths. Pitches are still generated on every clock, it's just the tregs which divide, so you can create foreground versus background. Back up to divide by 1. We slow the clock and dial in some decay to explore the effect of an external clock, shown on the yellow trace. Strange's external clock input is always listening, even when internally clocked, so in normal operation this provides an additional source of rhythmic complexity as it interplays with the internal clock. Again, this is more suited to experimental work, so for standard use, we'll hold down F sharp and turn X clockwise to switch the internal clock completely off. That short pause was Strange writing the clock setting to memory, so it's retained between power cycles. Like SIG, Strange uses our arbitrary clocking system, so it responds whenever it receives a clock, no matter how far apart they are. This lets us send it pre-composed rhythm, as here from an Eloquenza track. And notice how the treads respond, elongating or truncating as the rhythmic clocks change. They could just as well come from a Euclidean generator or piezo drum triggers. And Strange even responds to swing. Let's divide again. By 2. 3. 4. And 8. Back to divide by 1, and we'll take the swing off that external clock. Another of Strange's design goals was to provide maximum utility even when not using it as the center of your patch. First, we go back to internal clock by holding F sharp and turning X anti-clockwise. Next, I pull the oscillator out of the mix and then do something unusual. Patch Strange's treg output directly to a mixer channel. I then hold F sharp and turn Y clockwise, and I hear an A440 reference pitch. Strange has become an oscillator. The tregs are clocking fast enough to produce audio, and they track volts per octave. VCO mode, center becomes the octave range and rate is tune. Let me adjust the scope to put it in audio range. There, the decay treg is now clocking into audio, so it's a sawtooth waveform. And because tregs combine their shapes, adding 100% attack produces a triangle. And 100% sustain turns that to a trapezoid. Drop out the decay and the sustain to give us a rising saw, which of course will sound identical. Now, remember how strange is always listening to its external clock input? At BPM speeds, that just manifested as extra clocks, as we heard. At VCO speeds, audio rate external clocks produce Oscillator Sync. Stagger causes interesting stuttering effects with the sync sound. We can even apply clock division to achieve subharmonics or U-Tonality. The strange algorithm is of course still working, just very, very fast. Let's bring the external oscillator it's controlling back into the mix. Although the tregs are far too fast to articulate notes, we can still obtain a melodic line with careful use of row and delta. The speed is such that it's reminiscent of the highly ornate decorations of Pembroke Highland piping, or perhaps some of Terry Riley's early tape looping effects. We can also hear the effect of rhythmicizing the clock. Notice how gaps also affect the algorithm output. I'll just constrain the pitch window a little. All in all, then, Strange can provide a very capable VCO, thus justifying its place in your case, even if your current patch doesn't demand Strange's Melodic Contour Sequencing core functionality.